Hello guys, in today's video we're going to have a look at grinder reels and in specific line twist. Where does line twist come from? How do you eliminate it? How do you get rid of it? How do you make sure that when you cast your line out there is no twist in the line whatsoever? Right, to understand that, as soon as you understand that, it's easy to manage. So let me explain to you in the easiest way possible. What I have here is a small spool of line. It's very special, yellow on one side, and what I did is I made it black on the other so that you can see the line twist easy as they appear. It's very difficult to show it on the camera. That's black and yellow on the other side, so you'll see line twist very easily. So if we have no twist in the line like this, we turn the spool as if it's a grinder reel, so as if that grinder is standing there, and we wind the line up, my fingers being the bail arm. So now we're winding the line up, right? If that line is now pulled off the spool, there's your twists. For every single revolution that my hand makes around the spool, or for that matter the bail arm makes around the spool, every revolution there's one twist being put into the line, right? So just to show you again, there it is. Remove all the twists, gone, way off, and let's twist it on again. It's busy twisting onto the spool as if it's a reel. And now, instead of pulling it off straight, I'm going to open the bail arm on the spool. So we open it and we cast it off. And there we go, no twists. It's very simple. So the actual principle is twist on, no matter how many twists there is, and twist off. Alright, now once you understand that, then it's very easy to understand that putting a reel down like that and coiling it onto, so even if it goes off anti-clockwise and that goes anti-clockwise, the two will not cancel each other out. This is incorrect. You cannot do it like that. You cannot spool off in this manner onto the reel and think that you're going to cancel out the twist. And the reason for that being the varying diameters. This particular reel starts off at 26 millimeter diameter there and going up to about 65 when it's full. That, if you translate that into line twist per running meter, starting off at 12 twists per running meter, going up to 5 twists per running meter. On the other hand, this spool, which is actually quite closely matched to that one in size, when it's full, you're looking at 5 twists per running meter, but as it goes empty, it goes to 6.4 twists. And it's the reverse. This one goes from many twists to few, that one goes from few to more. So it is impossible to match the two. It's just physically impossible. You cannot do that. The only way to spool a reel, a grinder reel, the only way is to have your line coil off straight as if you are pulling it in from the sea, right? Coil it in straight and it winds onto the reel, and as it winds onto the reel, it puts the coils into the reel. I know the coils sometimes run in front of the line as you are winding it into the reel. That's normal. There's nothing funny about it. So sometimes the line doesn't turn around the bail arm nicely, so the coils, there are a few coils that run up on your eyes. It doesn't matter. When those coils eventually come into the reel, as you cast out the next time, they all cancel out and get, in any case. What you shouldn't do is you shouldn't force those coils to the front of the line. As you force them to the front of the line, okay, now fine, you've removed some of the twist in front of the line, but on your next cast, you are missing those coils and you actually needed them. So let those coils come into the line, into the reel, that's where they belong. On a reel that's coiled, as you cast off, they're gone. Okay, just as a matter of interest, if you had to coil from a reel like this, a big spool like this, this one goes from three twists per meter down to also about 5 twists per meter. So it's just impossible to match from any spool to any reel. Cannot be done. Okay, now, there is conditions where you will get twist into the line, and that is when your fish pulls the line. line has been twisted onto here, and if I now pull it off, the twists come out. That's when a fish pulls it. So if you happen to be lucky enough to get a big fish that's going to pull 100 meters off your reel, in this particular reel's case, the average twist per meter is about 7, going from a 12 to a 5, the mathematical average comes to about 7. So if you had to pull all 600 meters of line off your reel in that fashion, you will end up with 4,200 twists in your line, and it's physically impossible to get them back off, because as you coil it back on the reel, as you wind the fish back, you are adding another 4,200 twists onto the reel. If you cast it back out the next time around, those original twists remain and you cannot get them off. The only way to get them off is to get your line off in water, like for instance dragging it behind a boat, with no end tackle on it whatsoever, and let the water wash it off. Then reel it back on, let it go out again into the water, and reel it back on. When a twist gets too much, it's maybe easier just to re-spool your line. Now I'm talking about this twist specifically because I like to do a lot of drone fishing. And I've seen guys drone fish where they use the ratchet to pull against the drone. That is incorrect. If you go back to the 7 twists per meter that's on this reel, so pull it out, there's 7 twists per meter on. Wind it back on, you put it a new set on there. If you pull it back out again, you add another 7 twists. So it piles up. For every 10 times you take out your line, you've gone from 7 to 70 twists per running meter. 70 twists per running meter, that's unreal. And you will not be able to get it out. There's just no way of doing it. On a drone, you might be able to just put a little loop on the line, use a drone to pull out all 600 meters, drop just a loop, and then reel that back in through the water, and hoping that the water will remove your coils. I fear it won't be very successful. Now, some people say that if you add a proper swivel to your end tackle, that you can remove some of these twists. It's also not the case. No matter how good the swivel is, if you put any force on that swivel whatsoever, it stops turning. Unless it's a very well lubricated bearing swivel, it will not remove any of your twists. You'll still end up with a twist back on reel, cast out, new twists. So the only way to do it right is coil on, coil off, coil it on, coil it off by casting out and closing the reel. And that's it, guys. I'm not going to show you how to spool a reel. There's enough YouTube videos to show you. As long as you find one where the guy is spooling in this fashion, as soon as the guy starts spooling like that, skip to the next movie, skip to the next clip. Find one that is in this fashion, and especially if it's braid, make sure that the guy is putting on enough pressure on the line and how he's doing that. There's various ways, from levered gloves to proper nutted systems where you tighten the spool on a shaft and you can control it. Another way would be to wind it onto a multiplier like this. Wind your line on here, set the multiplier drag to the exact resistance that you want, and then going straight from the multiplier onto the grinder reel. Alright guys, I hope that explained where the twists on a grinder reel comes from, so that you can eliminate it in future. Tight lines, guys. Happy fishing. Cheers.